Thank you very much. The title of my report is Modeling of Cognitive Evolution Toward a Theory of Evolutionary Origin of Human Thinking. The plan of my report, initially I will note fundamental problems concerning modeling of cognitive evolution, two backgrounds for this modeling, sketch program for future investigation of cognitive evolution. Then I will outline several models, in particular models of planning by new Caledonian crows. Fundamental scientific problems. Modeling of cognitive evolution is directed to investigate the following fundamental scientific problem. How did human thinking origin in the process of biological evolution? Why is human formal thinking is applicable to cognition of nature? In particular, why are human formal logical inferences that are used in mathematical proofs applicable for cognition of real nature? Who was thinking about similar issues? Immanuel Kant investigated human cognitive abilities in certain approximation, an approximation of single adult human person. He considered our cognitive abilities a priori. And Conrad Lorenz developed approach from Kant doctrine of a priori to evolutionary theory of cognition. As Kant considers our thinking a priori, then he made a conclusion. The understanding does not draw its laws from nature, but prescribes them to it. So are humans able to cognize law of nature? Conrad Lorenz developed approach from in the well-known paper Kant doctrine of a priori in the light of contemporary biology, develop approach to evolutionary origin of our reason. According to Lorenz, Kant a priori categories and the forms of pure reason emerged during biological evolution. That is described in these words. Actually, Immanuel Kant and Conrad Lorenz demonstrated that without investigation of evolutionary origin our mind, there is no answer to the questions of applicability of human thinking to cognition of nature. Kant and Conrad Lorenz is a Nobel Prize winner, well-known biologist, and similar questions was analyzed by Nobel Prize winner in field of physics, Eugen Wigner, in the well-known paper Unreasonable Effectiveness of Mathematics in Natural Sciences. In particular, Wigner said that miracle of a prioriness of language of mathematics for foundation of laws of physics is wonderful gift which we neither understand nor deserve. Uh, the way to investigate of the problem, to analyze the problem, we can investigate models of cognitive evolution, of evolutionary origin of thinking. The most serious way is to study mathematical and computer models of cognitive of main cognitive properties of biological organism. And this study is a subject of new directional classification, modeling of cognitive evolution. Fortunately, there are backgrounds for modeling cognitive evolution in two fields. In the fields of computer science, there are several directions of in which models of autonomous cognitive agents are developed. These areas are simulation of adaptive behavior, artificial life, cognitive architectures, biologically inspired cognitive architectures, scientific foundation of artificial intelligence. On the other side, there are a number of biological experiments of animal cognitive abilities. I will outline several such abilities. Two experiments on New Caledonian crows. The first experiment was made in Oxford University. This is rather well-known investigations. I will only outline it. Two crows, the young female and older male, had the possibility to get a small bucket with food from a vertical cylinder. The straight wire and wired hook was near the cylinder. Crows quickly recognize that the bucket can be pulled out of the cylinder by means of the hook. At in some surprising moment, the male drag away the hook. In this case, the female tried to obtain food by means of straight wire, but it was impossible. Then she guessed to make a hook by pinching the straight wire in some cracks of the experimental set wire, and then bending the wire to prepare the hook. So after this, she obtained the food. Thus, the crows can invent a method of manufacturing food without any external help. One more experiment on New Caledonian crows. This experiment was made by a researcher from New Zealand. There is food in some deep hole. The hole is open only from the vines from the left side, and the food can be extracted by means of the long stick. But long stick is a buried toolbox. This long stick can be obtained by the short stick. So the method to obtain the food is the method of the solution of this problem is initially to pull up and release short stick, then obtain the long stick by means of the short stick, and obtain extract the food by means of the long stick. I will describe these experiments some in something. I will describe these experiments further, and I will describe our model that formalizes this behavior of New Caledonian crows. Another experiment was about ants. There are working groups of redwood ants. This group consists of one scout, ant scout, and several ant foragers. Ant scout, after finding the food source, comes in contact with its group and transmit to foragers the information about the place where is the food source. Жанна Резникова and Борис Рябко from Novosibirsk studied the behavior of these foods using small branching mazes. Each pass in maze was split into two branches, and there are several splitting levels in the maze. So this is initial positions for the ant. Then the food is at some there branching. And the final branch of this maze. Knowing the depths of the maze and the time of contact between the ants, Резникова и Рябко estimated the amount of food that was transmitted from scouts to foragers and the speed of this transmission. The speed was about 1 beat per minute. When the path is simple, for example, ant should move should turn to left in each branch, then the speed was greater. So the ant can use balls. The ant have some analogs of both Shinon and Kolmogorov conception of information. There are also simple maze. This is one channel and several branches. In this case, this is a description of what I said, that the results was that the transmission speed was about 1 beat per minute. And for simple ants can use simple form of information. In simple maze, the food was on a certain single branch, and the scouts, ant scouts, were able to memorize a particular branch with the food and transmit information to foragers. So the ants were able to count branches in some simple form. The main author of this work, Жанна Резникова, has a very good website. And she also has two books, in particular book on animal intelligence. Taking into account these backgrounds, it is possible to propose the sketch program for future modeling of cognitive evolution. These steps are from simple animal cognitive abilities to mathematical deductions. First steps, modeling of adaptive behavior autonomous agents that have natural needs, food, reproduction of safety. Second steps, to investigate the process of formation of generalized notions in animal minds. The next step, investigation of process of memorizing of causal relations in animal memory, and using memorizing predictions and using of these predictions. The next steps is investigations of logical, simple logical conclusions in animal minds. For example, actually at classical conditioning, where animals do simple logical conclusion, if conditional stimulus takes place, and the conditional stimulus leads to unconditional stimulus, then the appearance of unconditional stimulus is expected. This is memorization of consequence. The memorization of that conditional stimulus leads to unconditional one, and if conditional stimulus appears, then the animal expect the unconditional stimulus. Some conclusions in animals is similar to simple logical conclusions at mathematical deductions. Study, it is necessary to study of communication between animals and emergence of language. Basing of this sketch program, we made several models, and I will outline these several models. The computer models of simple agents, which have needs of food, safety, and reproduction. It is described in this box. The model of formation of heuristics and generalized generalized notions in this work. And this is rather simple models. And the next models are based on real biological experiments. The model of cognitive abilities of fish that cognize that analyze mazes and cognize mazes, and computer models of plant formation by human Canadolian crowd. I will describe this model. Crows are planning rather complex behavior using knowledge about elements of this behavior. I showed already this picture. There are three elements of the behavior: to obtain small stick, to obtain long stick, and to extract the food by means of the long stick. In the experiments, there are strong trained crows and weak trained crows. Here are names of crows, here are trials, Small trade crews obtained information about not element, all elements, and elements to obtain long stick. They didn't obtain information how to obtain a long stick from the by means of the short stick. There are three strong train crows, and weak train crows. Here, green color means that the solution is found. Blue color shows that solution is not found. And orange show that some solution is found by with some small variations. We can see that strong train crowds solve the problem at the first trial, and the weak train crowds solved the problem, but solved the problem, but the time was needed to solve the problem was greater. And two crowds, weak crowds, solved the problem only on the third and the fourth trial. In our model, we formalized this behavior. We suppose that crows were preliminarily trained to execute particular elements of three-stage behavior. There were strong train crows and weak train crows, and the crows use predictions of results of their actions. Here is current situation, current actions, and next situations. Some predictions were stored at preliminary training, and the other needed prediction should be guessed during the solution of the problem. The scheme of the problem, of the solution of the problem, is shown here. At initially, there is forward mental movement. At this mental movement, the crow guesses needed predictions with certain probability. Iteratively repeat this forward mental movement until the solution to the goal was found. There is also testing of the results, and then plan formation. This is results of simple computer simulation. This is dynamical probability of success. The success it is here is one is for strong trained crowds, and two is for weak trained crowds. Strong trained crowds solve the problem mainly at the first trial, and weak trained crowd need several trials. We also suppose in our model that there is a process of training, of testing of the results. This is based on this analogy with certain experiments that is described in these works. I will describe in works works in this box, the activity of hippocampal place cells in red on in analogous experiments was obtained. Here is shown there is a channel. Here is distance. Red moves along the channel, and then they found the food in this place, and then they replace of the backward the path of obtaining the food. In the next slide, it is shown the behavior. It is distance is here is the distance, here is the time. Initially, red are in the this place, and then it moves along the channel, and then activity of places of place cells is observed several times. If we consider this activity in more detail, we observe this this activity is backward in the backward direction. So we use some analogy that we believe that crow checks the way to obtain the goal. The main features of our models: the crow use predictions of plan formations. At plan formations, at initial forward moments, crow guesses needed predictions, and the crow checks the way to the goal by means of testing mental moments. The crow forms mentally the plan of goal-directed behavior. Concluding remarks. If you consider a sketch program of investigation of modeling cognitive evolution, this is models of natural needs, generalized notions, predictions, logical conclusions, communications, we can see that almost analysis of known models shows that there are already some small elements corresponding to each step of the program. So we can say that we already see small fragments of the picture, of cognitive evolution, but we do not see the whole picture of cognitive evolution. The sequence of serious canonical models, which would show the general picture of origin of human logical thinking, is not developed yet. There is a huge area of future investigations. Modeling cognitive evolution should have serious interdisciplinary relations with foundation of science, foundations mathematics, with epistemology, with cognitive science, with biological studies, with scientific foundation of artificial intelligence. Thus, we can say that investigation of cognitive evolution are directed to analyze the following fundamental problems: why is human thinking applicable to cognition of nature, how did human thinking emerge in the process of biological evolution, there are powerful backgrounds for this modeling. Studies of cognitive evolution have broad interdisciplinary relations. these studies should contribute significantly in the development of scientific point of view. The more details you can see. Oi, sorry. In this book. The book was published several days ago. Thank you.
Thank you, Vladimir. We currently don't have any questions on the app yet, but maybe we just have questions in the audience. That's a yes.
In the part of your talk where a crow is able to make a logical deduction because one stimulus is followed by another stimulus, is it not possible that the crow could be using statistical methods rather than logical?
There is no statistical. They obtained the relation at the first trial. But we can construct the detailed mechanism of this solution. I didn't describe it, but that it is possible to represent some possible mechanism. We can imagine that crows obtain some knowledge database in this mind. Initial situation, then obtain actions. This knowledge database is a table. Each row of this table includes initial situation, action, next situation, and the distance from the initial situation and the goal situation, and the distance to the final situation. Distance is the number of actions to reach the goal situation. Though using some knowledge database, the crow can select such action that reduce the distance to the goal. This is an assumption of our model.
The question is, most of knowledge produced by humanity, it's not the nature of human brain only by itself, but it's somehow product of society because brain didn't evolve several thousand years when the whole thing, you know, was evolved in a kind of distributed manner. So do you have or do you developing kind of a models which somehow addressing this distribution evolution of knowledge? Not by single brain, but by an ensemble of such brains.
Thank you for the interesting question. Of course, there is coordination between different. For example, we can consider scientific knowledges, and we can represent of a scientific cooperation between the scientists. And it is possible, I would like to note that in Palermo, at the BICO conference in Palermo, I propose some approaches to investigate the process of imagination by some agent physicist to represent some agent physicist who can analogously to Isaac Newton to obtain three laws of mechanics. And that's interesting. Approach to investigate the cooperation between the science by means of agent approach.
Any further questions? Oh, come on, guys.
Yeah, hello. I'm just wondering if you tried to collaborate with some AI researchers to kind of replicate this multi-agent CRO model in a way that it would be like almost one-to-one, a set of algorithms based on some, you know, AI. Thank you.
Sorry, I did not understand the question. Please explain in other words.
Yes, so basically, I think the diagram you showed, it was really interesting in the way that CROs just, you know, approaching problems, trying to plan ahead, learn something, fail, plan again, succeed, and so on. So have you tried to do some kind of experiments, like multidisciplinary, you know, experiments where the AI researcher would be trying to exactly replicate this kind of biological behavior through a set of different algorithms? It can be anything, like even hard scripted heuristics, whatever, maybe something, you know, Monte Carlo tree search with, you know, reinforcement learning on top, some other wild mix of algorithms, but the essential idea is to just try to exactly replicate some group of agents in this case. Thank you.
I would like to note that it is initial proposal of the direction of investigation of cognitive evolution. It is not in our. I would like to note. I would like to note once more, there is a huge area of future investigations.
Final question.
Not a question, but a remark. The word or the notion of information doesn't appear in your lecture.
What information?
What is information? The role of information in evolution.
And the question is, what is the role of information in evolution?
It is in another area.
Okay. So, we are almost back on schedule. Let's thank Vladimir again.
Thank you.